The cone is equals to 3.14 times 32 cubic centimeter divided by 3. So that is equals to 100.48 cubic centimeter divided by 3. So the volume is equals to 33.49 cubic centimeter. Okay, so this is mathematics 6, measurement. And our lesson is finding the volume of solid figure. And welcome to my channel. This is Maestro 05DX. And don't forget to like and share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. For our objectives, so we have to find the volume of solid figures such as rectangular, prism, cylinder, cones, and sphere. And to analyze and solve each problem carefully and to solve accurately. And for our preparatory activities, so let us have first a drill. Find or give the product of the following. Use pi as 3.14 or equal to 3.14. So pi r, if r is equals to 3 centimeter, so what is pi r? So that is 3 times 3.14, so that is equals to 9.42 centimeter. And then we have 4 pi r squared, if r is equals to 2 centimeter, so that is equals to 50.24 square centimeter. We have pi r squared, again the value of pi is equals to 3.14, if r is equals to 5 centimeter, so that is equal to 78.5 square centimeter. And 3/4 pi r squared, if r or the radius is 4, so that is 3 times 3.14 times 16 is equals to, divided by 4 is 37.68 square centimeter. And the last number is pi rh, if r is equals to 3 and the height is equal to 6, so that is equal to 56.52 square centimeter. Okay, for our review. Okay, let us identify the following figures and name the volume formula. So what figure is it? So this is a rectangular, prism, or pyramid. So this is equal to 1/3 times the length times width times height. How about this one? What figure is it? So this is a sphere. And its volume formula is equals to 4/3 pi r cubed. How about this one? What is this? So this is a cylinder. And its volume formula is equals to pi r squared height. This one, you have a cone, and its volume formula is equals to 1/3 pi r squared height, and this number 5 is, this is a rectangular prism. Okay, so this is equals to length times width times height. And the last one, this is, again, this is a triangular pyramid or prism, which is equals to 1/3 times the length times width times the height. Okay, let us proceed to the main lesson. Okay, so look at the figure on the screen. What is it? Okay, this is a cylinder. If you will notice, it has a three-dimensional shape with two equal and parallel circles joined by curved surface. And to find the volume, we need to get the product of the pie, the square of the radius, and the height. And to write that, this is V is equals to pi r squared height. And to apply that, let me give you an example problem. So, you have the can of a sardines has 3 cm radius and height of 8 cm. What is the volume? Now, by using the formula, we can easily find the volume of the cylindrical can. Okay, let us write the given input to the figure. So, R is equals to 3 cm and the height is equals to 8 cm. So, to rewrite, the value of pi is equals to 3.14 multiplied by 3 cm quantity raised to the second power times 8. So, that is equals to 3.14 times 3 times 3 times 8. We expand 3 centimeter quantity raised to the second power. And then we have 3.14 times 9 squared centimeter times 8 is equals to 3.14 times 72 cubic centimeter. So the volume of a cylinder is equals to 226.8 cubic centimeter. Okay, let's have this figure again, the second figure. Okay, what is this again? Okay, so this is a pyramid. It has an apex and a base, and there are three pyramids in a rectangular prism. We have the rectangular and square. And therefore, to get the volume of the pyramid, there is a need to divide the product of the length, the width, and the height by 3. So that is equals to V is equals to L times width times height over 3. Okay, now let's have an example. Find the volume of a pyramid using the given dimension with the height of 1.6, the width of 1.4, and the length of 1.8. Again, let us use this formula. V is equals to 1/3 L times width times height to rewrite. And to substitute the value to the formula, so we have 1 times 1.8 times 1.4 times 1.6 divided by 3. Okay, let's get first the product of 1.8 and 1.4 multiplied by 1. So that is equals to 2.52 squared meter times 1.6 divided by 3. And the product is equal to 4.032 cubic meter divided by 3. So the volume of a triangular pyramid is equals to 1.344 cubic meter. Okay, let's have your first activity. Okay, so a cylindrical can has a radius of 4 cm and a height of 12 cm respectively. What is the volume of a can? Okay, you can sketch or draw the figure so that you will be easily find the volume of a cylinder. Okay, so I'll be giving you 2 minutes to answer this. A radius of 4 and a 12 cm height. Okay, so to apply the formula, we have pi r squared height, which is equals to 3.14 multiplied by 4 centimeter quantity raised to the second power times 12 centimeter height equals 3.14 times, let's expand 4 centimeter quantity raised to the second power as 4 times 4 times 12. So that is 3.14 times the product of 4 and 4 is 16 squared centimeter times 12 centimeter. So you have 3.14 times the product of 16 and 12, which is 192 cubic centimeter. So the volume is equals to 602.88 cubic centimeter. Okay. This time, let us proceed to the next figure. Okay, what is this? Anybody? This is a cone. In geometry, a cone has three-dimensional shape with a circular base and a curved surface that tapers from the base to the apex or vertex at the top of it. So, in a simple word, this is the slant height, and here is the radius. So that is, its formula is equals to V is equals to the pi multiplied by the radius squared times the slant height. Okay, so that is the formula. Okay, let's have an example. Okay, so you have an ice cream cone. It has a radius of 2 cm and a slant height of 8 cm. Find the volume of the cone. Okay, so let us define it first. So this is the radius, which is 2 cm. And the slant height of 8 cm. Okay, to apply that to our formula na 1/3 pi r squared slant height equals 1 times 3.14 times 3 centimeter quantity raised to the second power times 8 equals divided by 3. So that is equal to 3.14 times 2 times 2, we have to expand 2 centimeter quantity raised to the second power, 2 times 2, times 8 divided by 3. Okay, so let us multiply 2 and 2 first. So that is 3.14 multiplied by 4 squared centimeter times 8 over 3. Okay, so the product of 4 and 8 is equals to 32. So that is 3.14 times 32 cubic centimeter divided by 3. And that is equals to 100.48 cubic centimeter divided by 3. So therefore, the volume of a cone is equals to 33.49 cubic centimeter. Okay, next figure. So what is this figure? What geometric figure does it show or represent? So this is a sphere. And a sphere is a three-dimensional round solid figure in which every point on its surface is equidistant. So this is equidistant from its center. And the volume of the sphere is given as V is equals to 4/3 pi r³. Okay, find the volume of this soccer ball. Okay, so let's have an example. The radius of a soccer ball is 11 centimeter. Find its volume. Okay. So, here is it. The radius, this actual size of soccer ball. The radius is 11 or the diameter of 22 centimeter. So, to apply the formula, so you have 4 over 3 times pi times the radius, so that is 4 times 3.14 times 11 centimeter quantity raised to the 3rd power divided by 3 equals, so 12.56 times, okay, so let us expand 3. 11 by raised to the 3rd as 11 times 11 times 11 all over 3. So that you have 12.56 times 121 square centimeter times 11 divided by 3. So that is 12.56 times 1,331 cubic centimeter divided by 3. And the product is equals to 16,717.361 cubic centimeter divided by 3. So, the volume of the soccer ball is equals to 5,572.45 centimeter. That is approximate. So there's still another number after 45.45. Okay? So for your activity number 2. Okay, a party hat has a radius of 3 cm and a slant height of 12 cm. So, find the volume of the party hat. Okay, again, you can draw so that it will be easy for you to solve. Okay, 2 minutes time to give for you to answer this. Okay, so let's say you have V is equals to 1/3 pi r² times slant height, which is equals to 1 times 3.14 times 3 centimeter quantity raised to the 10 power times 12 centimeter over 3. So that is equals to 3.14 times 3 centimeter times 3 centimeter times 12 divided by 3. So this is equals to 3.14 times 9 squared centimeter. Again, squared centimeter, squared is not outside the parentheses. It's because if it is outside, you are multiplying it by 2 again. So times 12, so 3, let's move, divided by 3. So that is equals to 3.14, and the product of 9 and 12 is equals to 108 cubic centimeter divided by 3. So, and that is equals to 3.14 times 180 is equals to 399.12 cubic centimeter divided by 3. And the answer is equals to 113.04 cubic centimeter. Okay? So, to recap what we have discussed. So, why do we have to study volume of solid figure? So, why do we have to discuss it? Does it help us? Can we apply it in our daily life situation? How to get the volume of a cone? What do we have to consider in getting the volume of a cylinder? And for our evaluation, so answer the following. So find the volume of the following solid figure, then choose the letter of the correct answer and write it on your paper. So the first question is, a can of milk has a radius of 4 cm and a height of 10 cm. Find the volume. So you can choose the answer. So you have 502.4 cubic centimeter, 520.4 cubic, and 205.4 cubic, and 402.5. Don't guess the answer. Solve. And for number 2, a conical hat has a base or area of 16 cm and height of 15. Find the volume. So, 240, 25, 250.12, 80, and 83. And for number 3, spherical ball has a radius of 12 cm. Find the volume. So you have the given A and C and B and D. And for number 4, a square pyramid has a base of 5 cm and height of 15 cm. Find the volume. This is a square pyramid. Is it 135 cm, 375 cubic, 75 cubic, or 125 cubic? And the last one, a can of pineapple juice has a radius of 4 cm, height of 7. Find the volume. Okay, so you have A is equal to 351.68 and 117.22, and letter B and D is 341.68 and 171.22 cubic centimeter respectively. And that's it. And thank you for watching and listening.